Welcome to the Black Thumb Patio Garden. In this case, Black Thumb Texas Garden. We're at my property here in Athens, Texas, or near Athens, Texas. And I've gone so far as to buy a little orchard of trees. So I've got 2 pecans, 2 peach, 2 pear, 5 raspberry bushes. They're in pretty tall, nice ones. And we're trying to get everything in, including an irrigation system. And so that's what you hear in the background is actually my very good friend and contractor, Keith Williamson. So if you ever need any work done in the Athens area, he's your guy. So let me show you what's going on. So that's Keith on the backhoe, digging the hole for the irrigation system. And in fact, he dug all the holes for the trees as well. I forgot to do all this for the raspberries. I keep saying that. I wish they were raspberries. That's my favorite fruit. And so here we've got one of the blueberries, and there's a line of 5 of them here between these 2 oak trees. And so, inside this hole is some tree and shrub garden soil from Stay Green, and some all-purpose landscaping sand, and some soil acidifier, and mixed in with the clay that's here, probably a few leaves and some twigs and other things that fell into place. So let me show you where the irrigation system is going. And it's about 300 feet, 350 feet to get back here from the house. And you can see the pipe is already being cemented as we speak. And Keith went crazy here with the depth of this hole, because it really only needs to be 1 foot down. Otherwise, we can't use these little baskets to house our timers that are gonna be feeding off the drip hoses. So I got 2 kinds. I got the same one that we used in the Black Thumb Patio Garden, which is this porous tubing. And then I also bought the one that has the holes built in. And that's pretty much it. And then as soon as we're done, I have little flags to show where everything is so we don't run it over later on. So this is the bag of plumbing supplies that we're gonna need to have in order to install all of this. And we're just taking a break after we did the raspberries. And then what's going on top is in the blueberry case, the Sierra red mulch, because that just happened to be here. And then over here we have Texas native shredded cedar mulch. And then these guys are getting this stuff, which is, what is that called? Black velvet? Black velvet premium topsoil for Texas soils. So we'll see how that goes. The general idea is to dig a way bigger hole than you need. And then because it's a lot of clay here, we're only using about 1/2 bag of that topsoil. And throwing in a bunch of leaves and twigs on the bottom, which I already covered up so you don't get to see it. But it's just your, you know, dried out oak leaves from last year and a lot of their twigs. So there you see a couple of twigs sticking up. And that's it. And then you mix this stuff together and you hope that the fruit tree doesn't get so comfortable in this hole that it doesn't root straight out to the sides. And so we're making sure that the sides are very rough, and that should make it work out for the roots. All right, more later. So one of the things that they recommend on YouTube is to put like this dried leaves, better if it's composted, but don't got. And then lots of these old sticks when you have a clay soil, because then soil is not so hard. So this is what we're gonna try. So here's what the hole looks like. We've got all the dried leaves. We got the compost or topsoil, and then some sticks. And then we're gonna throw some clay in there and plant the bare root trees. Alright, so we're finishing up for the night, and just wanted to show you this is one of the pecan trees. You probably can't see it, so let me get down, but you can see there is some netting. It's a very, very light plastic net that is supposed to be deer fence. So what that means is the deer won't eat it. Well, we're going to find out. So we've got to be careful around here. So we've got fence post stakes. We've got the deer netting, we've got twine that's holding the trees in place, and that's all we can do for now. And so they have to be watered, so I gotta buy 300 feet of garden hose so that I can bring the water back here, because we're still in the process of putting in the irrigation system.